y'all know the tennis preacher, the prophet, the psychic, coming back at you again with another video. Okay, people, I want to respond to one of the commenters that they commented under the video where the video that was titled "The Djokovic Greatness versus Nadal's Greatness," and you know I was giving my the Djokovic greatness versus Federer's greatness, and you know I gave my a final conclusion about what I thought about the Djokovic greatness, and I told you where I thought he was ranked. And but now this commenter, I sort of had a little problem with the comment. Now the commenter, this is what he or she said right here. Okay, the comment was actually really good until she said what I had a problem with. Okay, now she said that she gave the Djokovic a prompt. She said that she's ranked the Djokovic above Nadal because she said that the Djokovic has always had a consistency that Nadal didn't have. And so now y'all know the tennis prophet. When I hear something, man, if I hear something that doesn't sound right, y'all know me, I'm gonna pick that up. Now let me just say something now. I know, listen, if she would have said in a vacuum, in other words, if she was talking about Nadal by himself, or maybe saying, well, the reason why Nadal is not greater than Federer, it's because maybe he has had injuries. Now, I've heard Nadal fans say this. The reason that they're saying that Nadal would have already surpassed Federer if he hadn't got injured so much, have been plagued with injuries through his career. So, but now, if she would have said that's why Nadal is not greater than Federer, or why he hasn't surpassed Federer yet, okay, I would understand that right there. Okay, but that's not what the commenter said. She's comparing Nadal to Djokovic. She's saying that she's putting Djokovic over Nadal because Nadal hasn't been as consistent over the years as the Djokovic. Now remember, y'all, I said that the Djokovic is in the Dow category, but I still would rank the Djokovic the Dow over the Djokovic. I would put them in the same category, but I would put Nadal over the Djokovic as far as greatness. Okay, and like I told y'all, you know, the Djokovic can go. Y'all can rank him in different spots. That's why I told you, somebody could put the Djokovic number one, the best ever. Somebody may want to put him number two. Somebody may want to put him number five. But we have already talked about that. The Djokovic, you know, he can go in different places. Some people don't know really where to put him. But let's get back to her comment. Is that true that the Djokovic, and this is important for the greatness debate between Nadal and the Djokovic. We're not talking about the better player, but we're talking about career-wise, okay? All the whole career. Now, that's important. Now, people, I got a serious problem with this. Now, remember I told y'all, I'm thinking the opposite of the way this commenter is thinking. The reason I got Nadal over the Djokovic as far as greatness is concerned, remember I told y'all, if the reason why the Djokovic is probably not the GOAT, the reason why he's not the GOAT over Federer is because it ain't because he got hurt now. Now, of course, if he wouldn't have got hurt, he could have surpassed Federer. But people, listen, that's not the main reason. That could be a little bit. The main reason is what he didn't do before his peak. Remember I said it in the video, and this is why I'm going to disagree with the commenter, because she's saying that the Djokovic has been more consistent over the years than Nadal. People, that's far from true, and the numbers speak for itself. People, listen, besides the Djokovic peak from 2011 to 2016. Okay, of course the Djokovic was, I would give the comment of that the Djokovic was, not only was he probably more consistent, he played at a higher level than Nadal, and he dominated Nadal during his peak. But people, we talking about the whole career. We talking about, and that's what the whole greatness is about, especially when you're ranking people. People, listen here. If you eliminate the Djokovic 5-year peak, That's one of the best of all times. It's not the best, if not the best, one of the best for sure. People, the Djokovic doesn't really have a great career. He has a very good career, okay? He did win the Australian Open in 2008. People, y'all know, remember I told y'all I didn't even like the Djokovic back in the day. He used to tank games, acting like curios. Sometimes he'll half play, quitting. He quit a few matches and all kind of nonsense. He had a discipline problem. I mean, sometimes he would play good, but now he was more successful than curios. But still, he wasn't great. Great. But people, so y'all understand what I'm saying? Now, let's get with Nadal, people. I got the role now. I got to go, well, where's Mr. Melvin Marshall at? Melvin Marshall is the bit Nadal fan. I got to jump on the Melvin Marshall bandwagon with this one. People, listen here. Nadal, even with his injuries, people, I just went through Wikipedia just to make sure. Could I be missing something? People, it's even better than I thought. How do y'all think he got 16 majors? People, listen. The one thing Nadal has done since 2004, whenever he won his first French Open, people, do the math. How does he have 10 pretty well, except for the year that Federer won, okay, and the year that the Djokovic won? I don't know if there was one other person. I think that's it. Pretty well, Nadal at least won one major a year since 2004. The Djokovic can't say that. Outside of the Djokovic 5 years, the Djokovic hasn't been winning anything. Okay, so, but and not only that, people, Nadal has stayed up until like 2015, when Nadal was really plagued with injuries and everybody thought maybe Nadal would retire. Nadal was always in the top 10, top 5. So Nadal, if you add up the years, he's been more consistent than the Djokovic over the years. I'm talking about as far as winning majors. Because why do you think he got 16? And if anything, people, Nadal made sure if he didn't win another major, listen, he definitely got that French Open every year. And how many people can say, how many even great players can say they won a major almost every year? Even Federer went into a drought, people. Y'all know that after 2010 and stuff. Even Federer, he was struggling to try to win a major a year. Even Federer lost control of winning the Wimbledon. I mean, he lost control of that for a couple years or 3 years. So Nadal, though, I have to give Nadal props. Nadal was always consistent about at least winning that French Open. And if you go to Wikipedia, except for 2015 when his ranking dropped, Nadal was still, man, I know he laid off a year and a half. I remember when that Rosol guy beat him in the Wimbledon. He didn't lay off a year and a half, but he laid off 6 months or 7 months or something like that because he was injured. But Nadal quickly came back, rebounded, and hey man, got that French Open and got those 10 French Opens, got that, got those 3 U.S. Opens, got those 2 Wimbledons, got that 1 Australian Open. Man, so listen, man, Nadal, he has been consistent over the years, even with the injuries. It's no way he could have 16 majors now. Okay, people? So, but yeah, he got the Djokovic. I'm talking about being consistent as far as winning majors. Outside of those 5 years, how many majors did the Djokovic win? What, 1 Australian Open? That's pretty well it, I think. Yeah, he could have won one more, but I'm telling you, yeah, but y'all can check on that. But he definitely won 2 before 2011. Okay, but Nadal, that's why I got Nadal over the Djokovic for his greatness. I mean, listen, I don't have a problem with the commenter saying that she's putting the Djokovic over Nadal. That's not the problem. I told y'all the Djokovic could be equivalent to Nadal, and if somebody want to put him over Nadal, I got that. But it's the reasons she gave. She said that the Djokovic is over Nadal because he's more consistent over the years. No. Not, man, Nadal has been consistent for 14, 15 years, and it was just 1 year to 2015 when his ranking really dropped. And then even that, people, he came back in 2017, and the Djokovic hasn't even done that. Y'all see the Djokovic? You talking about inconsistency. Look at the Djokovic now. He got to prove he can come back and be consistent the way Nadal. Look at Nadal right now. Nadal is set at a high level to win the French Open, but Nadal, he came back in 2017, Federer and Nadal, and both of them won 2 majors and at least 3 Master Series tournaments. At least Nadal, I think Nadal won 3. Yeah, it had the most historic clay court season and won its 10th French Open. So, man, no. Nadal is more consistent over the many years. The Djokovic was just really consistent for 5 years at the high level now, okay? I'm talking about consistency as far as winning majors, okay? And big achievements. Okay, people, tennis preacher, prophet, psychic, signing off. Nadal, I got to do some more. Nadal is more consistent, okay? Over the many years, believe me. Tennis preacher, prophet, psychic, signing off.